Prime Minister Narendra Modi today visited Shauryanjali, a commemorative exhibition on Golden Jubilee of the 1965 war in New Delhi. The Prime Minister met families of war martyrs and paid tributes to the immortal heroes of India's victory over Pakistan in the war. The Union Cabinet has approved a scheme to transform rural areas into economically, socially and physically sustainable spaces. Named as the Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Urban Mission, the government has earmarked over 5,000 crore rupees for this scheme to drive economic, social and infrastructure development in rural areas. Addressing the media after Cabinet meeting in New Delhi, Communication and IT Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad said, under the mission, 300 clusters will be developed over the next 3 years across the country. The Cabinet also approved providing additional 50 days of unskilled manual work under MNREGA over and above the 100 assured days in drought or calamity-affected rural areas. The Reserve Bank of India has decided to grant in-principle approval to 10 applicants to set up small finance banks under the guidelines for licensing of small finance banks in the private sector. The in-principle approval granted will be valid for 18 months to comply with the requirements and other conditions as may be stipulated by the RBI. The central bank would consider granting license for commencement of banking business only after compliance of requisite conditions by the applicants. In Jammu and Kashmir, Pakistan troops violated the ceasefire 4 times since Tuesday night as it resorted to heavy firing and mortar shelling on forward posts along the line of control, prompting the Indian forces to retaliate. The firing and shelling by Pakistan comes close after the Indo-Pak border guard talks in Delhi, during which it was agreed to not to resort to mortar shelling and end ceasefire violations by devising new strategies like joint patrolling in some areas along the international border in J&K. Marking a historical event, the rivers Godavari and Krishna were formally interlinked by Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu at Ibrahimpatnam village near Vijayawada. The interlinking of the rivers is being made possible under Patti Seema Lift Irrigation Scheme on Godavari River at Pattisam village in West Godavari district. A local court in Lucknow has ordered police to file an FIR against Samajwadi Party Chief Mulayam Singh Yadav for threatening an IG rank officer Amitabh Thakur and probe the incident. The incident triggered a massive row in Uttar Pradesh recently. While accepting Thakur's application, Chief Judicial Magistrate directed SHO Hazratganj to file the FIR under relevant sections and apprise the court. Insurance benefits for dependents of EPF members has been raised from ₹3,60,000 to ₹6 lakhs. The decision will benefit 4 crore employees from the private sector. The condition of continuous employment of 1 year under current employer before being eligible for insurance benefits has also been removed. Total production of Kharif food grains as per the first advance estimates this year is higher by over 37 lakh tons as compared to similar estimates for last year. Though the overall rains have been lesser than last year, the timely government interventions have resulted in better results. The auspicious 10-day festival of Ganesh Chaturthi will begin with much fanfare from today. Lord Ganesh is considered to be a symbol of good fortune, wisdom, prosperity and wealth. 2 Indians have been abducted in Sirte in war-devastated Libya, even as 2 other nationals remain in the custody of Islamic militants for the past more than 1.5 months. External Affairs Ministry has said all efforts are on to ensure the well-being and to secure the early release of the 2 Indian nationals reportedly detained in Libya. UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon has slammed Hungary's treatment of migrants as unacceptable after police fired tear gas and water cannons at asylum seekers at its border with Syria. The UN stressed that these were people fleeing war and persecution and that the response must be one of compassionate leadership. He added that they must be treated with human dignity. In China, over 100 people, including 92 children, were hospitalized after a major fire broke out at a flower shop in the country's eastern Fujian province. Firefighters and residents rescued all the children attending a kindergarten on the second floor of the building. However, many sustained injuries. A total of 104 people, 92 children and 12 adults, were rushed to a nearby hospital. All are in a stable condition. The cause of the fire was not immediately known. The United Nations has called for a special court to try war crimes committed during the Sri Lankan Army's long conflict with Tamil Tiger rebels. In a long-delayed report, the UN Human Rights Council accused both sides of atrocities, especially during the final stages of the war in 2009. Sri Lanka said it would hold a domestic inquiry but would not allow the UN court, which would have foreign judges. Railway shot putter Manpreet Kaur became the latest Indian athlete to qualify for next year's Olympics when she shattered an 18-year-old national record en route to a sixth title at the 55th National Open Athletics Championship at Kolkata. She threw 17.96 meters in her second attempt to claim the gold medal, a hat-trick of titles at the National Open. She broke Harbans Kaur's earlier record of 17.43 that had come in 1997.